straight into mid. It's going to be a brawl within the first few seconds, and already Cena and Zeke have put themselves in that advantage. We expected this one to be a fist fight, a brawl throughout. We know that Ascend like to take teams on that individual skill. For now, though,
Maurice.
We're going to see them split again. Maurice has managed to come in from behind. The shot's connecting and actually drops spike the spike. Down, although they've been isolated by the Sage Ward, this now becomes
different agent. MW0 has the recon that just coming online. Has been sort of playing in that kitchen position. Maurice might have got more than he bargained for, and he still makes it work.
This is one of those rounds where they're playing it as a bonus. They do have a few rifles available, and there is one of them. He has just taken the head clean off of Zeke, and that was the Lurk play. The rest of the team making their push, but they are moving into the majority of that Killjoy utility, and you can see the rest of the team already running on the rotation.
Ooh, Murray's maybe wasn't expected to get spotted by that recon that considering, and I'll see Ned up on rafters, just seeing if he can catch any plays. Look at this movement though from Heat, he's just jumped onto the spot. Bone Cold at least catches him, and MW can take out CNED at this point. Starzone now trying to up this tempo. The trades are good.
No, incredibly good. It's left just
there when it comes to strategies, but the play is tighter. That to me is much more interesting from watching those games before. But now you were saying about that.
The whole team is now here ready and waiting.
Yeah, there's no flanks around. That's exactly what Keylice is checking, but now we might actually go on a bit of a lurk. He's realized how much space is here, and Zeke, the rest of his team are retreating, but he's headed away. Vivaki don't want to take that risk, and they can't because Zeke is still going to push. Murris does eventually take him down.
Yeah, but he's wasted enough time. The rest of the team set up ready and waiting. CNED's operator will put a second in the grave. And
one enemy.
Well, this round in itself is looking grave. A cleanup for the drone just to make sure his position wasn't revealed. And as said, the rotation so far from Vivo Keed has been spot on. They've got pretty much every player ready and waiting, but Zeke's Empress allows him to not only find that opener, heal up and escape, and CNED has just popped one more. Ascend starting to roll into this ace.
Nico, when it comes up, had to buy up that operator again. So saving these guns is important, so Ascend are doing well here. He can just keep chipping away. It's not like Ascend have been winning streaks of rounds in a row. Their economy is going to be okay, but not ideal. The fact that CNED versus Heat is going to be interesting in various ways other than who gets the most killing grids.
The timing here is going to be everything. They didn't spot out Heat, and he's already taken off two heads. Not the start that they were looking for. He waited for his moment and found it perfectly. Still a good chance here, though, for an afterplant, but actually, straight away, we're going to see the Hunter's Fury. They're just patiently waiting to see if he attempts another. Tagged him, but Bone Cold will survive. This should allow him to... He's just connecting everything. Put into his crosshair, and you can see the confidence. He's running straight in. He spots the man at the back, but Bone Cold takes him down. Still a 2v4 scenario. Some weaker weapons on the remaining players, so there is still quite a lot to do. And Bone Gold, he might catch a player with the Aldro now. A free kill for him at least, but his teammates being pressured. Killers needs to stay alive, and actually, his pit's about to drop. Players low on the other side, a chance to try and clear them up, but it will be Muris to put him in the ground. Quick push through mid, wall to isolate. Three players actually looking in this direction, though. A good opportunity for Muris, but he's taken down almost instantly. Still, though, a couple of other defenders, and along with Bone Cold's Hunter's Fury, this execution looking a lot better. They need a response, and they need it soon. And while Heat, this time, I don't think there's a hero to be found.
Bone Cold, I'm in two Hunter's Furies in 8 rounds now.
Not bad. And they win this one with 4 players alive. So any chance of really destroying that economy that could have come through, a lot more passive from Vivo Keed.
Yeah, some of that post-plant or anti-plant utility coming out of the side of Vivo Keed. Not really connecting all that much onto the Star Zone. To the point he's actually just staying in that spot. Defo likes to do it a little bit. Hops up onto the high ground, Bone Cold with a recon. That's going to see if any players come through on rafters, and it's just been watched keenly. This is a really nice post plant from Ascend, but Vivo Keed still in it, dedicating the res as well. It's just Murray's left.
Oh, CNED's going to walk into him. Turns it into a 1v2 scenario. He's getting smashed with utility, but doesn't take much damage from it. The tap, and he actually gets the conversion! This man moves on to the Killjoy and find every... Yeah, the worry for me is that that last retake only worked because of a clutch. Now, sure, this is a completely different scenario, but Ascend have done well for the most part in these scenarios. The Lurk play as well from Zeke is already going to shut down one, and they expected him to leave. Instead, Starzo sticks around! He's going to pop the head of three! And leave just one man standing. He doesn't care that he's been detected.
Okay,
it doesn't matter. He gets the first one, but he's got 4 more to find, and Zeke is lurking behind. They do still have two.
Yeah, they still have two.
I guess they just want to fight. Oh, dear. Okay. maybe a little bit over-aggressive that time from Heat. Try to find someone on the B side. It's not where CNET has been. Now, I guess it's because they've also used the Viper's Pit on A. So they've tried to lock down that side of the map, and on the other side, the Viper's Pit ends up actually just being their own teammate. That is an interesting pit, though.
Yeah, and Zeke...
Haunting here, I'm on my own. Is he about to get shot in the back? He is! Just had no idea! They've been completely confused, bamboozled by Ascend, and it leaves just two players left, Ryan, to try and bring back around where I'm sure they just...
I love that Ascend used that time.
Oh, no! That's
up. Because right now, he's just planted face first into Ascend's sightline.
Oh, this is aggressive already. They're going to get things back into a more even scenario, and it has to be the fallback of the opposing Jett and Heat. They haven't even managed to get themselves a spike down. This is a retake before they've even got the plant. Ascend just come running through, and it's left all onto Vixen. It seemed like they...
If you're looking at Heat, he's only got 25 armor, so even though this is a full buy only just in some of these cases, but despite going down, there's no lurks, there's no cute plays from Ascend, even though you are taking the attention for Vivo Key that are kind of watching behind him a little bit. Yeah, Zhao is playing very close.
Ooh, that's... I'm wondering if they're going to try and counter all this. Starzo has his own that he might just look to try and peek out. They're going to already clear out one, but with the rifles in hand, they should just look to spam it through, and the cleanup doesn't take too long.
From Vivo Key has been pretty impressive so far.
I like the attempt, but... peekaboo spot out from Zeke hasn't worked whatsoever, and there's a push coming straight in up to the side. They're just looking to try and run this one straight through. Mur is leading the charge, and he's managed to get quite far. I don't know if they've realized that he's got all the way through, and Phone Cold's going to be the one to catch a bullet for it. Now Killers is in a horrible spot. He either has to face the wrath of the full team, or try and catch them on the way, and he does exceptionally well. Starzo even going to wall up over the top, try and battle them, but he takes the brunt of the damage. A 2v2 scenario in the lurk coming through from Heat is not going to be expected at all. It's left on to Starzo to try and bring this one back, and he gets nothing. He push him down. There were plenty of players ready and waiting. Even still, though, it is going to be the plant come through, and he manages to get the opener.
The Viper's Pit being down, though, is not really too much of an issue. The lurk was attempted from Joe, but in fact, moved away. I think he was caught by the turret setup in the end from Murris. And now the Hunter's Fury coming through, trying to see if he can catch anybody as another Viper's Pit's dedicated on the defense, the attack this side even. It's a bit of a mess, but Ascender coming out.
Yeah, they're doing well from this!
What?
That's just a triple, a quad spray down from MW! What is the response here? MW0 is already going to tag him at the back, so he's going to be isolated. But Starzo, he's managed to thread the needle. He gets nothing, though. The turnaround from Joe. We mentioned that fragging ability. That might be the most important kill of the round. Still, though, Bone Cold trying to do something in response. He's actually... Kill might be everything. I don't think he actually spotted the gun barrel pointing through. He's going to catch him with a dart out. A teammate even helps as well. It's left on to CNED.
It's on to Bone Cold. Keylights is still lurking around there. But MW0 yet again is dead.
Straight after the pause, straight after their opponents try and adapt. Vivo Key pick up the pace. They're going running straight in towards this site. Zeke's already dead, and it's Murray's again. Two kills to open. Starzo at least is able to respond. The orbs already being retrieved. Maybe trying to get a little bit closer to that res. Joe is going to get himself another. Still quite far away from bringing a player back, but they might not need it at this point. CNED has found one, but a cost of a lot of HP. There is, however, a res on the other side. Ascend would need to try and find a player here, and Bone Cold has been brought back, putting them in an advantageous spot. Killers has found another, making this one look more than possible, but he still stands alongside MW0. These two have been unbelievable thus far, but now it's just on to one. It looks like an impossible scenario. 10 HP to try and kill off two. The shot dart isn't really going to do anything. Bone Cold tag, but it doesn't matter.
Yeah, and the fact that Ascend have been struggling in those kind of rounds, we haven't seen them have those insane clutch outs. And MW0, Aether's not really going to be too much seen. And Viva Kid at this point, not over-aggressing. It's just straightforward post-plant, sit-back, Killjoy lockdowns, creating a lot of different space. And the Resurrect if they need it.
And on the other side of things, sure, there's a couple of ults that are not far away. The Bladestorm, also the Empress, just one kill needed to get either of those online. They've got a lot still to do. Already getting spotting out. They've got this retake wall available. CNED is going to get two already. Looking like this is possible, but Vixen fighting. Looking to try and spray them down. It's left all on to Heat. One Praetor in hand. He's been spotted! But what is that flick? He's found himself one. Just trying to bait seek off the defuse, and he's already done it. Just leaving it down to this last player. A whiff spot, but he's buying time. And Zeke is just trying to stick it. He is going to close it.
For a very good reason. But can VivoKey truly pull off the upset?
It's whether Joe can sort of keep up to pace with the Viper. So far, he's under a lot of pressure. Starkso is there to try and chase it up. And MW0 not faced six screens to his advantage. But there's a couple of bait plays out, and Frenzy wins against Starzo, who was already pretty low health, to be fair.
Yeah, they've gone for this almost old-school, original strat of just getting yourselves that afterplant out through the bathrooms, but MW0 just looking to fight through. CNED will trade. You've got the paint shell of Zeke making things more awkward. They've still got three players standing. They've used the utility that they had, but realistically at this point it becomes so awkward for the remaining players. Zeke with another, leaving it all on to Heat to try and pick them all off. And even
just being Heat delivering the show, he's been doing that, but supplemented by the rest of his team.
The sort of bait and run. Heat's gonna have to try and pop off here. Now they are just walking back through, already garnering some control towards Lamps, but this might just be to leave a snake in the grass. I think it's been expected, it's been spotted, and Heat is not going to fall for it.
Quite rightly, Keyles, I think this was one of the reasons why we saw Ascend 13-0 in Gambit, is just that Keyles was able to get so many nice lurks, the utility posted towards the A site. Heat isn't falling for it, there's some Astro utility coming out just to break this execute from Ascend. The Resurrect dedicated, and Stars are going down, it's just farming up for Heat and MW0, and it's as clean as... That's unfortunate, really, and seen it with the start. I like this default, though. Things are slowing down. Now Keyless, again, like, knowing that there's going to be an element of bait out on the side, and Starzo using that dissipate nicely, and that was a dissipate from the side of VivoKey as well.
Yeah, I don't think that Murr's expected that to disappear in front of his eyes. I don't think he expected there to be other players there, and now MW0 is the only one standing within this site, hoping to try and blind someone with the flash instead. It is Starzo with his triple, leaving just Joe. And those are the sort of plays that I do think that I worry a little bit. Because that from Vixen, as said, like going into this map, they're going to be feeling incredibly confident. I think it is
a bit of a defensive just really break on through. Seekers on the defense is going to find a lot. Vixen sneaking up on it as well. The trade's still working out in the favor of Keyles. Yet again, this is just like this.
They are struggling at the moment. Heat. We've seen him in one round manage to pop off when they pushed into his crosshair, and Bone Cold, well...
Still without a kill, I think.
Just to see what sticks.
I think this is about to become very difficult already. Straight away, Zeke just clearing out this hoop without a raise on it, and it's just getting worse. They're just pounding ultimates into the site. Nice shot from Heat, though. And the quick rotation from the remaining players could make things a little bit awkward. Starzo has spotted out Murris, but there's going to be a swing. There's going to be a peek back in.
Nice
and
trade.
Joe has managed to find another. And they're slowly being closed in from behind. Now the spike is going to be retrieved. Joe is just being tagged down. He's going to have to try and swing out of that one, but he manages to escape, still keeping himself alive.
Meaning, Vixen now is starting to crunch. Maybe Zeke is holding on. He's doing relatively well in comparison. And now, and it's
the Ascend decided to throw in a couple of ultimates just to try and keep it clean.
Two smokes
as well.
And it's
come down into a 1v2 scenario. A chance to isolate the jaw, but Zeke is just...
play, though. They're sort of expecting maybe more plays to be over A. The rotation is slow, but still elbow control is pretty nice if you're in a position of Vixen. There is a Cosmic Divide as well to break up the site. The Viper's Pit, this is a nice position. We saw Nats using it yesterday. The defenders are still just walking right through it into that elbow spot.
It's going to be a tough retake, though. If your whole team is trying to make a push through elbow, it's going to leave you with some isolated jaw. And CNED, there's a little bit of a ledge. He can just swing out. This might just be the murder of every single member. Vard is watched. He is going to connect the shot. It's left to Zeke and Bokold to try and hold on here. The Molotov falls, but it's actually only going to deny one. He's managed to find a second. It's already halfway tick, trying to do it all. And the timing, is it going to be enough? Just trying to get the defuse through, and it's not. That Molotov just waiting for their opponents to push. They just run straight into this ace.
Sticks get holding them back.
They're all spamming the box. It doesn't seem to matter, though. This man is just landing every single shot that's put in front of him. Finally, Vixen will get him down, but there is just so much utility. This is why this composition is so ratty, that they're just getting wrecked by Molotovs, by snake bites. They're going to see this run through almost instantly. I thought that was going to be the kill, but in fact, it's Heat that goes down. They will retain this extra control, but Zeke is just on fire. Again, he's going to just multi-frag them out of the round. This was a purchase from VivoKeed.
They are paying them enough, finding that extra kill, and now they get the operator back. But
It was just very early utility coming out of Vixen. He has no clue. They're still going to try and fight it. And Morris, well, he's harder to move. Doesn't really have any more slow orbs. He's just going to try and stand and face and forces the teleport over from VivoKeed.
Ooh, better from Joe. He's managed to isolate a kill, keeping himself alive, and Zeke hasn't actually been able to spot him, surviving at least for the moment, just hiding behind that utility, and the Viper finally comes online. Two impactful kills that could make the difference to get them their third round onto the board. Lots of utility. Actually, Xeno's going to be pulled, but still manages to get himself the plump. The lineup comes through. This has gone from a retake A to a retake B in a matter of seconds, and actually MW Zera has caught killers as he attempts to rotate. It's a bold strategy. I'm not sure if it was intended, because sending the spike through first definitely had its risks, but it has put them in an excellent spot.
Look where MW Zera is as well. Like, he's keeping Starzo in an awkward position, but knows that he needs to move away. He needs to help out his team in his post plan. And Bone Cold, bit of parkour to help him get up onto the high ground. The flash is a bit awkwardly timed, makes it awkward.
What?
Vixen traded out from Zeke, and Starzo now holding onto the site. MW0 blocked off by this wall. I think he can get around it, though.
What? Well, yeah, he might have to at this point, because they're just sticking the defusal, holding it all the way, and no one gets there in time! Ascend! It looked like they were done after that rotation.
The Astro utility to force him out, but considering this is not really all that much, like the utility being forced up, it means that Astro Util is so important. Another bit going to be used, and now Starzo pushing through. This is what you want to see, just using our utility to peek out, catch a kill, and dismiss. And considering VivoKeed are constantly pushing through a shot with no split, they don't really have a leg to stand on, even if this spike does get planted.
Try and hold them in position as they wrap back around already. Starzo finding another into the round. He's got Bone Cold alongside him, but the trades are coming back. It's left on to Heat again. A few opportunities, but while he's doing all of this, Bone Cold is slowly making his way through, and these baits are just not working whatsoever. Zeke just holding the line. Although he's been spotted, he has no idea that Bone Cold is in. Four spies in this half from VivoKeed as they've got to go for another.
It wasn't really like the 200 IQ lineup as well. It was just close enough.
Don't push me.
Yeah. Effective. I wonder why.
Xeno getting pressured. Heat's just got past.
I realize as well, like, being able to just wrap around like this, because there's been zero showers pressure coming in for VivoKeed. They just five-stepped through one part, and really, Ascender ready to just smash this one to death.
He's just running in behind them, not even trying to slow down. He does a lot of damage, but doesn't take the kills. But even still, he's bought some extra time. The shotgun doing damage, but the trade's coming back thick and fast. And it's left onto Joe. He's being naded into oblivion. There is no chance at survival, and it will be that defuse. Ready. Mira's tag desperately low. Starzo, we're seeing him on the Viper. We didn't even really mention that, but that is not something we expected to see coming into this series. A switch up for quite a few different agents as the sky goes missing on their side. And, well, we know that VivoKeed, they like this more puggy style. These individual players looking to try and pop off, and this time it's Joe finding a couple, but again, it always seems to swing back into these two versus two. The overhealed Murr is in a pretty good spot to try and find something here. Slightly whipped, but he gets one anyway. And now it's left onto those in-game leaders facing off for who has the biggest brain, who can bring home this round. And Joe, he's in the spot to hold it, and he's going to find the headshot to close.
Right, whenever you use a neural theft.
That's not a true fact. Just to be clear, we're joking. Xeno isn't. I like this angle. It's just in front of where that last 20 from Murray is. A good read.
So
on
close,
how
he's going to get him in the end. Just the spam through. Obviously, this is the bonus round for VivoKeed, but CNED has had enough of his opponents coming back. He's back on his jet, and he is slaughtering them. Only Vixen can put him in the grave. And while eventually Bone Cold is going to close out
the halftime with the desk, is just Breeze is going to be pivotal to whatever teams want to do well in this tournament. And CNED, well, he's happy to keep on farming through.
CNED has just put them in the ground again. Some isolated by the utility holding them back on that.
With two hops, it was already hard enough with one at this point. I think another big thing is going to be Vixen surviving. It's a nice toxic screen. It's very default with what you expect, but it means that utility has to be sort of thrown out. They really wanted to put Murray's under pressure.
Oh,
and it's even the operator that gets the kill in the end. Nice shock dart snake bite combination and the fragment catching him on the get-go, okay. But still, Viva Kida holding on.
Zeke trades things back, though. Both players isolated within the cave. They need to try and find a way to push out, and instead, Zeke's looking to push in. He's got Bone Cold spamming through, and although MW0, he has a chance! Here. He's going to get all three! Again, this man! And
they're going walking in. They're trying to sell this as if it's an identical take. That's the plan. Go moving in directly through.
And although Baitstar so looks away at the worst possible time when it comes to that double DOS control, and because of that Bone Cold isn't really expecting somebody to be right in his face, Kiles is on this site, he's got a lot to deal with.
Doesn't get anything for him. A little bit of utility to deny them. Hasn't actually worked out. But they've cleared a lot of these close angles. This round definitely isn't done, and by the looks of it, it's going to be the cave after plant that's set up now for that attacking side. A single snake bite remains if they want to attempt it. Realistically, Starzo can actually just walk past this utility. Instead, he decides to shoot it, use that Viper's Pit, and they're not going to kill him off before it pops. This makes things a little bit awkward, but with Heat close up, he might be able to just kill them off before they go for any sort of defusal. They don't expect him to be this close, and it's left onto scene, and first shot landed, but the time is ticking, and it doesn't seem like there's any chance in hell he'll be...
So he's also such an aggressive fighting position. Again, just that Poison Cloud in that spot. I mean, it works. It catches Vixen on the way out. Not really an angle that you expect a Viper to be playing from. It's not quite ratty, it's out in the open, and Starzo, that's the kind of, even from his personality, he's that good at it. Now it's just a full rotation coming in, then the null command. Now suppressing abilities, but it's not really affecting Joe, and on that Cypher, he can maybe face a little bit more.
This is starting to fall apart, but Zeke finally steps up to the plate. He is still landing shots, though. Lightning fast reactions, putting this into a 2v2. 30 seconds left.
30 seconds left.
Got to try and clear out Zeke. And well, the Blazestorm going to be popped. They want to try and isolate this jewel. The timing going to be everything. And Heat lands the shot even while slightly blind.
Bone Cold again.
It is left into this 1v2. They are planting in the spot for Heat to just hold the angle. To clear this out is going to be incredibly difficult, and MW0 I think has already spotted him, just trying to bait him in, maybe not expecting anybody to just be holding this cross. He gets the information and the tag through, but he again connects, even on low. Walking straight into CNED's lair, the operator in hand already. Going to slow it down. And there is a fairly aggressive spot from Killers that they do have to watch out for. He'll have heard the footsteps, the flash is solid.
So I do like the fact that Starzo is changing it up a little more. Utility in various places, more anchoring towards A. And that's just because CNED is getting so much success with this operator. He can make it fall with the...
Come on! He won't go down. However, Bone Cold has fallen. Because of that, we might actually see a switch up. Heat has found a pick on the other side as well, leaving
30 seconds
just a
left.
Few players remaining. Not in the worst of spot, but they're going to be pincered in. CNED can only land one, and Zeke just trying to survive. They have been isolated one by one from the side of Vivo Key. A solid attacker side round. And well, what are the chances here for Killers? Completely out of position. A rotation versus a Viper's Pit, and four players waiting.
And we were saying, like in the other series, the round 12, Ascend were the ones that were bringing out little curveballs. That's the first time that we've really seen Vivo Key presence in mid, getting that kill. And again, the timing to go.
To take this one over the line, Ryan, are you a believer?
We'll have to see at this point. I said that this pistol's going to be important, and it certainly was going to be for Zeke. He's almost doubled the kills that he's had in the server just off this pistol alone in the first 7 seconds. Now that Util is going to be fired in onto B, it was a site that was held loosely for Vivo Keed. And just as we were sort of saying, mid-control on the attack for Vivo Keed, they didn't really go elbow at all on the attack, but that's where they went instantly on the defense.
It may be a hard read, but whatever it is, it's still worked out for Ascend. The timing for MW0, though, couldn't have been any better. He's brought things back into a 3v3 and looks to move over to his teammates. The peak from CNED is also going to be dropped. Joe, he was quiet individually, but he's now coming up big for his score once again. It's left on to Zeke. I believe he might even have to ace it just to take this one home, and it is not happening. A 3v4 to a 3v...
from Joe. I reckon that's going to pick up a couple.
Spike planted.
Oh, plant at least. Realistically, now it's all about damage and heat. Not going to allow for any of it, just popping heads as he goes, leaving Killers as the last man standing. Absolutely no chance for him here in a blaze. Oh, here is that blaze storm. Aggressive peek out. He not quite managing to escape.
All of these players pushing for double door. Hold it to see if they can catch a player on switch. I like the idea from Vixen. Just peek out, try and catch a monster not looking, but it's a bit more tight play from Bone Cold.
Oh, if you say that, he's about to lose his life. Well, eventually, Killers will be there with the trade, but this round is still not over. A 2 versus 3. Any more kills than this, and after plant, looking decent already. Utility not going to play a part in this one, really, for the side of Ascend. It's more just those individual battles, the team play, the synergy, the crossfires, and while just waiting on the other side, it should have been an easy kill. Eventually, Will running into the site, removing the dash, but he's managed to reposition just off the edge of it. Still going to be caught, and actually just takes Zeke down straight away, of course. Opportunity to get res, but never mind. Already the headshot coming through. Joe desperately wanting... But they have to watch out. There's a flank coming in. Killers could end this round in its tracks, but they're getting aggressive enough that they might be able to kill a few of the players before they come through. Vixen will land the shot as they wrap back around and leave this now onto just two players, the flanker, but more importantly, CNET. He's the one with the angle onto the spike, and he gets absolutely nothing. Just one player down, leaving it all onto Killers. He finds the bird, but he cannot close out Mura's.
Having something at least a little bit extra, but hiding in this corner is not going to be checked. It's a freebie, and now he can just back away, wary just in case someone's going to try and peek up and trade him out, but he'll escape before anyone will be able to respond.
It was also just a 50-50 decision, making a recon that was in the hands of Bone Cold to try and clear him, but they decided against it. Like, in these scenarios, they're not sure what they want to do. Protocols have been better, and now Mura's can sort
into that upper bracket match.
And across, like Viva Keen in this series, the mechanical skill is there, the firepower, we knew it would be. But just the team play, just the ideas, the defaults, the executes, the post plans, everything is a lot sharper. Now this looks like a Brazilian super team.
Yeah, this is what we've been waiting for, and while Starzo there's waiting back behind, looking to try and push in alongside, and the flash is good, and he eventually, it's a labored spray, but he gets the kill nonetheless. The spike yet to cross, so still not directly committed, but with two players already in, you'd expect them to make their way through, just waiting for the screen to be recharged. But look at this wraparound through mid.
Spike planted.
They also still have a bit of utility to throw in to try and catch them off. Mura's has a little bit of spray. Vixen trading up CNET, so again, it's this high line. Keyless managing to slip through. You need these kind of moments. And now what's Vivo Keed's buy like?
To Vivo Keed, what 100 Thieves did to them.
Yeah, at least the rest of Ascend Assault are coming together now a little bit more. CNET really not having the money to...
About to just launch himself straight into the site. And look to put the pressure onto Joe, and he's already gone. So much utility just forcing them back, although there is a trade. The Hunter's Fury actually finding a couple attacks here and there. Heat has managed to get another one, and this leaves Zeke isolated on the site. The remaining couple of players just trying to hold from the back lines. The wraparound from Bone Cold could be absolutely everything.
Yeah, that elbow control is going to be so important, but they really need to help out Zeke in this situation. There's an important kill for Bone Cold. Zeke is still holding on, but Heat is putting up the pressure. He's starting to try and cook the KO alive, but Mura is actually getting behind
Zeke. One more, a 2 versus 2 scenario, and they have to clear this man from the flank. It's left all on to Zeke to try and close this one out, but it isn't going to be happening.